Listen, 7 Nightly News.
Blues, the big edge they need and deserve the way they're playing. Madden, drop putt, it's a good one. Another one.
The siren, Carlton's added a point, Hawthorn 4 points, the margin 17.
Well, we've got 3.5 minutes left in this exciting third quarter that has seen Carlton come from 9 points in arrears at half-time. Williams, Condon gives the hand pass back towards the 50-metre line. Baxter gives it away. In goes Crawford, he's down. Free kick anyway.
Against Ratton. There it is, Hyde.
Well, that was fairly undisciplined, wasn't it, by Brett Ratton? I'd suggest that he's been reasonably good for most of the afternoon. But he gives Crawford the chance now to have another ping at them. Ratton, 12 kicks and 10 hand passes. Crawford coming from the interchange bench. Chance to kick Hawthorn's 9th goal. They've missed a few in this quarter. Crawford doesn't miss this one. So back come the Hawks. 9-10 to 10-15, it's 11 points in favour of the Blues.
And again, Robert, we just emphasise those little mistakes, and that's an undisciplined area. That area there, they could have controlled that, but those little things have turned the game against them at times, Carlton. They deserve better.
Crawford's first goal. Hawthorn coming back. 11-point margin, remember the Blues led by 20. Lawrence out of the centre. Poor kick to McKay, who plays on immediately. A couple of chances here, Scholl and Bradley, they could raffle it. Scholl's taken it, Bradley calls him on. Drop punt pass, Langford in the front spot. Welsh held it up well to Ulio with pace. Tucked away in the pocket, little drop punt. Oh, Ronnie's done it again. That's his third. He's kicked 2 goals, 3 in this quarter. 11-15 to 9-10. And a very big answer, that one.
Yes, and he's one of those players that had to stand up and be accountable. And
he's
to tell you what,
quarter, hasn't he?
Oh, my word. Langford, they did the right thing, but then Diulio just taking advantage of his pace. And again, it's not easy to kick goals when you're running that pace and to make it worse from that pocket. Terrific effort.
Yes, it really was a good kick by Ronnie Diulio. 3 goals in a 20-goal game so far is very important. Matten gets it out of the centre. He was favoured by the bounce. Oh, nearly a mark there. No, it should be a free kick anyway. It will be. Heaver. Brown being dragged to the ground, but it's going back to Brent Heaver. He probably should have taken the mark. He went for the chest mark and it bounced straight off. He goes into the pocket, looks for Welsh and finds him. Actually, he's added a little bit of a dimension, hasn't he?
Yes, he's the target they've needed. Sporting's just drifted out of the game, so they needed a tall player to go there and take a grab. If he gets away from Langford, he's good enough to do something like this.
Well, he's kicked 1 goal. It was an absolute boomer of a kick earlier in the quarter. And this is an important kick with 1.5 minutes left in the third term. Here goes Welsh. He kicks long to the goal line. It's helped over for a rush behind of the Blues. So a bit of an anti-climax in that build-up. Rowan Welsh, 1 goal, 2. The Blues lead 11-16 to 9-10.
Ayres looking for an option or two. 13 scoring shots to 6 in this quarter in Carlton's favour. Ayres goes long and wide. Langford was the target. Welsh stuffed it away. Heaver on the run. Normally a great kick for goal. That's a goal. A good one. A beauty. They're going to be hard to beat now.
Well, what a quarter by the Blues. They kicked 6 goals, 8 to 1 goal, 5 by Hawthorn, turning the match right around, and at three-quarter time led 12-16 to 9-10. So a 24-point margin as we go back to the match at the start of the final term.
Start of the final term at Waverley Park. Carlton leading by 4 goals, 12-16 to 9-10. Madden and Lawrence. Madden wins it. He has won most of the day. Jarman into the centre square. Scholl, Bradley, clever. paved it out wide, but Pritchard able to get the first clear kick away. Only as far as Dean, who dropped it, recovered. Has time to balance up and go with a long one. Jarman's hurt himself in the centre. Gowers thumps it away. Christo waits to Heaver. G. Collins rode him into the ground. Free kick. Heaver's a long way out. He's got some options out wide. Hannah was one of them. Williams is still on his own. Still on his own. Well, he can't wait forever. Now Heaver goes towards Welsh. Stretch, getting back Nugent. Christou takes it off him. Can he get it back to Scholl? They run it out. And gee, Greg Williams had stood there for, I reckon, 15, 20 seconds on his own in the pocket. And here's Jarman's incident, just going down awkwardly. But he's back running now in the pocket. Tapped away, taken by Ratton. Good kick, right to the square. Sporting, well played, Gowers. 12, 17 to 9, 10. Gee, Hawthorn wouldn't want the Blues to get the first one here.
Well, it's interesting, Bruce, a few years ago, Carlton determined what was called the premiership quarter, the third one, and it certainly was today. Terrific effort by all players in that team in the third quarter.
Langford to kick the ball back into play for Hawthorn. He comes to this near side. A high kick, punched away by Scholl. Taken by Big Harry. Somehow he was able to get his kick away. Carlton mark taken by Christou. Well, how did Madden get his kick away?
Well, he used some evasive skills, Robbo.
Well, no Hawthorn player wanted to try and knock the ball out of his hand or try and restrict him from getting the kick. And the ball is finished with Christou. And a pretty good game by this young man. He's kicked one goal. This could be a telling blow for the Blues. Christou, long raking drop punt kick is a goal. So the Blues draw first blood in the last quarter, much to the delight of their fans. 13-17 to 9-10.
Well done, Justin Madden. It was a good effort to get out of that congested area. As Robbo said, there should have been someone going at the footy, but they just stood around. Gow's not able to get the Jarman. A very ordinary effort to try and get rid of the footy. And Christo, who's played back through the middle of the ground and forward this season, has done very well.
Good kick by Ange Christou.
Biggest margin clearly of the day. Madden another touch. 13, 17, 19. Christou again. Gowers against the flow. The bounce favouring Carlton. Heaver couldn't quite take it. Langford stood up pretty tall then. Handball was okay to Crawford. Run sideways. Couldn't quite get it to Nugent. The tackle was okay. Paul Deer on the ground. With him Sexton, who will run it towards the boundary and I think will be pretty happy to panel it over as Kernahan's getting ready to come on. 13, 17 to 9, 10.
It was an interesting little run between Deer and Sexton. Deer, who hasn't had much of in the play at all, but outrun easily by Sexton.
Yes.
Madden and Lawrence again wrestling and jostling for position. Lawrence backs back into him. Madden to Williams. Williams's left-hand handball was perfect. Dean ducked his head when he was being challenged. Taken by Baxter. Good tackle by Scholl. Play on court. Jarman's quick kick around his body. Blacken out numbered. All good mark Sexton. He's a Dow defender. Athorn takes it. Kicks it to centre wing. Good kick too to Scholl. Found him beautifully. Carlton's right on top here.
Dean off for Kernahan.
D'Ulio the front spot. Jenke at the back and takes the mark.
Well, I think Brett Scholl will be disappointed with the penetration of that kick. Jenke a little too tall and very sure. Kicks back near the wing. McKay, a big punch, goes back towards half forward for the Blues. Brown, no one questions his ability. He may have been throwing it. No. Oh, down goes D'Ulio. Crawford goes after the football. No whistle blown, so get on with it. And that's exactly what Crawford did. Back towards the centre. Carlton overrun it, but it's Sexton. Handball over the top to Brett Scholl. In turn, back towards the centre. Taken by David Kernahan. He pumps it to the 50-metre line. Punch from behind. And D'Ulio, after a brilliant third quarter, has made just two little errors at the start of the last turn.
Yes, and one was contacting with Paul Cooper, who's in a bit of trouble behind play.
Ball clear for Ben Allen. Allen's kick to right half forward. Out in front is Hudson. Elvin keeps his footy. Goes after the footy. Gives it back to Bradley. Bradley gets it somehow. Welsh. Here they go again, the Blues. They're deep at half forward. Brett Heaver goes, backs himself. himself against Langford. Williams, watch the creativity. Hand pass into the path of Heaver. Goes down, collects the footy. Oh, he's down again. No free kick and the Hawks will get out of trouble. It finishes with Jenke.
Goes wide to Collins at centre wing. Hannah gives a free kick away. No play on. Cool. Hannah takes Collins on, then gets his own free kick. Play on given. The Williams handball was okay. Welsh goes long. Right there to the square. Sporting front spot. No, Mark, play on. Hit the ground.
It was a great effort, the umpire.
Wasn't it?
David Howlett nearly paid it, nearly paid the effort.
I think it hit the ground, Robbo.
Yes. It did hit the ground.
Great effort though, Bruce.
Great effort.
Great effort. Oh.
Big Earl, who's played very well today. A goal here, and you reckon that'll be Curtin's? It's a big lead, this. Nugent, running at him, Scholl, out of play. To think that Hawthorn in the second half has kicked one goal, and Carlton's kicked seven goals, 9-1-5. What's the story with Peter Dean, Gerard Healy?
Well, he went straight into the race and was inspected by the doctor and the club physio. He's got a problem with his back or perhaps even his ribs.
Inside 20 minutes, Spalding. Kicked brilliantly, smothered by Gowers.
And Steve Lawrence has been taken off the ground. Jason Taylor back on.
Well, Hawthorn have got to outscore the Blues by 5-1. And they've only managed 9-10 at this stage of the game. So it's a big task for the Hawks. The Blues dictating play. The ball kicked clear by Cooper. No mark. Yes, top effort. Not paid. Bradley paddling the ball and it paddles it over for a boundary throw in. Paul Deard dumps him, but Craig Bradley quickly to his feet. 13-17 to 9-10. Down to 18 and a half minutes. Madden to do the ruck work against Paul Deard. Deard tries to get the front posse. Madden will not surrender. The ball going back near centre wing. Ratton leaves it behind. Hawthorn just with persistence. Get it clear. Jarman, handball. They run beautifully. Tony Hall and Crawford. Crawford's kick towards full forward. No mark to Alvin. Can't get clear, but Dunstall's got him and he didn't have the football. Play on! You take it, Bruce.
Hudson to Taylor, goal. 10-10 to 13-17. Well, you know what he did, Robert? The umpire played it, holding the ball.
Correct, that's what he did.
And said, keep going, man. Fox getting a break there, 10-10 to 13-17. Still in the picture, 70 to 95 on Seven Sports scoreboard. Deer in the ruck now against Madden. Madden wins the tap. Bradley charges through from 70 metres, kicks the ball to Welsh. Great mark! A beautiful mark against Langford.
It was a good effort, wasn't it? Not all that much experience, but certainly Chris Langford. What about Bradley screaming through the centre?
Yes, the plaudits coming to the acting captain from his teammates. Bradley with great pace. Good stuff.
Good kick too.
Welsh has made a difference since going to full forward. He's kicked 1-2. And he's going to kick from 20 metres out, straight in front. And the Blues go further ahead. 2 to Welsh, 14 to Carlton. Cooper coming off for Ayres. And Carlton are 31 points in front again.
Yes, Cooper having some trouble with his vision after some contact with Dulio. Now Ayres having to come back on. A good play there by Madden, also by Bradley particularly. There's a little tap, but a great mark by Rowan Welsh.
Oh, you'd love to be on the forward line on the end of kicks like that though, Ross, wouldn't you?
Oh, well, either end would suit, wouldn't it?
Just penetration with the kick was fantastic. He's such a good kick on the run, Craig Bradley. 14-17 to 10-10. Paul Deer, what a job he's got. He must be giving away about 20 centimetres in height to Justin Madden. Madden runs straight at him and gives away a free kick. Oh, he's got to be going the wrong way, surely he is. It's got to be a free kick for Paul Deer. And the umpire went one way. Greg Williams thought it was theirs, but Paul Deer takes it and kicks it in short where Darren Jarman has marked. Chris Stu just a little further away. Jarman gives it to Jenke. The Hawks have got a chance here. Jenke's a good kick under normal circumstances. Alvin gets back. Dunstall can't take the mark. And it's run over by Hudson. And for whatever you want to say about Stephen Silvani, I know Dunstall's chances have been restricted by kicks not coming in all that well, but he kicked four goals, and then Silvani switched onto him, and he's been goalless since then. Madden falls over. Condon, handball, Tony Hall, quickly off the left foot. Dunstall, well done, forced his way into the front posse, and has taken the mark about 35 metres out directly in front.
I agree with the Robbo, though. Silvani has been good. Just been around, just been tapping the ball away at the right time. Played him close.
Gee, he's never to be denied, though, is he, Jason Dunstall? Four goals. And if he kicks this, the difference at the moment is 31 points, so he'll pull it back to 25 if he can kick straight. Nobody of this big crowd has left the ground. It's been an entertaining contest. Dunstall goes for goal. He really misses those. He's kicked his fifth. ...25 points now the margin for the Blues. We've got 15 minutes left.
Yes, and the ball getting down there initially because it was a good effort by Deer in the centre of the ground to put his body in. He got a free kick and they eventually got the ball forward. And the result after a few minutes is a goal to Dunstall. So let's see how Deer handles the second bounce.
Goals for Dunstall, 92 for the year. Hawthorn hanging in, 25 points in arrears. Madden and Deer, 11-10 to 14-17. Madden clearly, Jenke, well played. Condon was tackled fiercely. Christou got a little kick in. Ben Allen's kick out wide, gives Jenke the run of it. McKay takes off after him. Jenke holds his ground very well. The handball wasn't good, too far for Jarman. Bradley's had a very good second half. Alvin, quick handball over the top. Brown, he should get a free kick. Jarman just got hold of him.
Played that well, didn't he, Brown?
Oh, yes, he's a smart player. No point Darren Jarman asking what was it for. The older player didn't have the footy.
He's had 21 touches. Brown, he's been good. Very consistent player. Smalling and Madden with the Flyers. Scholl, well done to Christou. It sits now back to Scholl. Good play. Back to Christou. He'll kick this. Ange runs in and goals.
Bruce, very good between two youngsters.
Three to Christou. 15-17 to 11-10. And that really is symbolic of Carlton's domination in the second half. What yes. happened there?
And also good stuff by Brown, who's now had the compliment of having Darren Baxter on him to tag. And they just deceived Nugent here well enough. And then no one running it, Christou, at all. And an easy goal in the end.
So a very good game from young Ange Christou. 17 kicks, 6 handballs and 3 goals. Back to 31 points the margin. Bradley again, but the tap by Madden was perfect. Spalding clean bowl. So was Welsh. Centre half forward. Ayres in trouble. Christou, important little touch. Platton goes down. Hawthorn was right there with him. Ben Allen takes it away. Kicks it wide to the wing. Well done, David Kernahan. Gets away from Tony Hall. Kicks it very nicely. DeHulio into the pocket. And Welsh takes the mark. Rowan Welsh has kicked 2 goals. And Bruce, you were asking where the goals were going to come from Carlton. Well, I'll tell you. Brett Ratton 1, Scholl 1, Heaver 1, Brown 2, Bradley 1, DeHulio 3, Welsh 2. And Christou 3.
I'm surprised it took you so long to mention that.
I wanted to just push it home, Roscoe.
Just for the record, I agree with you. I've got all those marked down.
Rowan Welsh for his third.
Sitting on 98 goals. Our commentators are Drew Moore for Dennis McKenna. Dennis.